So there was this question on the IRC channel about a single service executable file that needs to be needs to run in separate instances with separate permissions. So you can do it in like three ways, I guess. You can basically use only MCS to create some separation only between the two instances, so the two instances have the same domains, so have the same permissions, but they are basically separated from each other. Or you can basically use type enforcement, which basically allows you to do basically both separation as well as different sets of permissions for each process. And you can also do both, so type enforcement and MCS, which basically allows you to use the type enforcement for different sets of permissions and separation to some degree, and then basically on top of that use MCS to basically add more separation, so basically override some of the type enforcement rules. There might be some case where you want your both daemons to have in a type enforcement point of view to have access to a single file, or actually to that one wouldn't work with MCS either, but have access to some single type of content, and then use MCS to basically isolate that. But anyways, let's just think about this for a while and see how you could do that. Now, if I am not mistaken, I've created and that's the wrong password. I've created some thingy in the past. But seems I no longer have it. Oh, it's, do I have, where's my timers? I don't see any timers here. In the past I did create some timer, like systemd, system, I guess. I don't know if I still have it. Grab timer. I think I no longer have it. What's it called? Jeez. Can't. Can basically crying out loud. I need to get the IP address. Oh, actually, I don't. I just open it from a local perspective, if that's possible. 192.168.1.104, I guess. No. 122. I just don't know the. I just don't know the fucking IP address. DSP. DNS mask and DHCP. Leases, where are my leases? That's not it. Anyways, I'll do it the tough way, I guess. I don't know where my leases are, and actually I could just basically system control restart container one. Hopefully that works. And then less var log messages to get that stupid IP. We have some ABC denials here, but where's my damn IP? Isn't it getting any? Oh, here it is. It's hundreds, and then basically. Four words, 80. Yeah, this is some things, something I keep doing manually for some reason, and then basically go to netkb info WordPress, and where is that thing with my timers? Here, timers. Okay. Yeah, this basically shows you how to create a simple script. Alright, so I'm going to just basically use this. So basically I'm going to create a script, and I need to go to my virtual machine. So nano user has been my one shot, and then user bin bash, and then basically echo test date and then yeah, and that's shitty. I need to parse some configuration file. How would I go about that? So there would need to be some configuration file where I can tell it, and actually I can do the following, I guess. If 0 equals, actually, serve S0. Not sure if this is going to work. Yeah, that's basically, and then my one shot text, and I'll do a pend. So, and then exit EOF. Yes, ls all z user has been my one shot well I'll be damned has been. All right, now tmod plus x, and then I'll copy this over. Make there my one shot, and cd my one shot, and then just create a policy for it. I need to create a policy for it. So nano my one shot te, and then policy module my one shot, then just create some type my one shot t, type my one shot exec t, then make that an init daemon domain, init daemon domain my one shot t, my one shot exec t, and I fucking typos all over the place, and then basically a systemd daemon, systemd type my one shot unit file g, and then systemd unit file. I'm not sure if this is right. And then I'll just actually set permissive my one shot t. This should provide a base. Make f. Oh, actually, I need to also take care of the file context. So user has been my one shot, and then system gen context system u object r, and then my one shot exec t and s zero, and then also what is it? I'll need to I'll just try this lib systemd system, and then my one shot service. I'll just this like this, and then gen context system u object are my one shot. Unit file T see if this builds make F user share as Linux deval make file and it actually builds SE module e my one shot pp. It's loading. Restore conv user has been god damn it my one shot fuck so there's a bug already. So back to the file context file, there's a bug in there, and of course that stupid S again. Stupid mistakes. Yeah, go. Restore conv and now it's set. Now let's take care of that unit file. Ls lib systemd system. So I'll just use etc. So my one shot service nano and I'll paste that crap in from my website and then just edit that. See if that actually blah 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 type one shot and then basically user my one shot and then give that a serve. Oh, actually, instance one, I guess. See if that actually works. Nope, there's another bug. I'll just use this for now, but it's not, it shouldn't be needed. So I'm probably doing some something wrong. Probably use a lib instead of lib. Actually, it's most likely that. Now I'll be damned. Be damned, what the hell? What am I overlooking? I should just look this stuff up. As he manage of context list. Grab unit file. User lib system the system. Okay, that in theory that should make it work. Then why doesn't it work? Now it works. Okay, so 740 just ls serve instance one make their instance one. Serve instance one and then system control start and then my one shot ls alz serve instance one and there it is. So that actually did work. I'll search MHCTS recent and decided to allow that stuff out it to allow. So here we have the stuff that it actually needs. So let's just add that to our policy. Nano my one shot TE. Add this here and we're going to basically create a new type type my one shot var t. I could call it my one shot content t, but my one shot var t. Actually it's this is a wrong name. I'll just call it data t. Data t. And what's happening is, whoops, the following. So this is it actually running. What is it? Echo, I guess. Here it's reading password file, which is a shell doing that. And here this is basically. So here it's actually doing the following. It's adding an entry to. What is it? Serve instance one. So if I make this instead, do it this way: one shot data, my one shot data, my one shot data, and then here also my one shot data. Now, what I just do then is basically I'm just installing that there, and that's also the right way to go about that. Serve instance one, and then this basically do this here, and actually do the following: instance one, and this is basically a dir, so dir, and then just add that context. Um my one shot data T, so that the dir is labeled correctly, but as far as serve my instance one, and then this, and yeah, basically everything should probably be none, but I'm not sure if this is the right way to go about it, but let's just see if that's, and let's make that, and I have an error type in line 12, the type enforcement file. Damn, the system is pretty damn slow, and it's also pretty damn hot. And again, and it's a file type, not file type, file type. Jesus, this is lagging. And now, of course, I need to also take care of some types. So I'll just, actually, I'll just use the policy core command exec. I use the macros instead of raw policy exec bin. And then it's basically my one shot T. And then it's auth read password. Shit, it's lagging. I'm not sure if that's my one shot T, if that's the right thing. And then kernel read system state, kernel read system state, my one shot T. Let's see if that actually builds. And that actually built, so I have that right properly in my mind. I can translate that stuff by just making guesses, thinking about, okay, what may be intuitive? What would I call those things? Now, I'm going to restore on that serve instance one directory, and if all is well, then it should only reset the directory and not try to reset the contents in there. Restore con rv serve instance one serve. Yeah, so it does it right. It says no warning, no default label for the file in it, but it does actually do the directory. So, but there's also some other stuff that I need to do, but I'll just, actually I'll do that right away. I forgot that, it's stupid, I should think, because if you want to basically go there, then you also need to traverse it, so. So basically what this basically expects is that you install that that my one shot or that serve instance one dir. So that's not actually created on the fly, that needs to be installed. So if you create that script, then you basically should take care of that. So let's just rm serve instance one, and then that text file. Stupid typos. So yeah, now just try it again. Service my start, or actually yeah, start my one shot. And it's not service, damn. system control. And now ls alt z var serve instance 1, and now it's created, and then my one shot text, get that. Okay, so that's done. It pasted that in properly, or it put that in properly. So actually in the process was running our search avc ts recent. See if we overlooked anything. Either to allow that. Yeah, this is all old stuff. So it should work. Set and force 1, and then also go into the file of the policy and make that enforcing. So remove the permissive statement and then make it again, install it again. Just make sure that it works, that it just normally works. Yeah, hello. All right, so now it's enforcing. Let's try that again. And the directory is empty if all is well. It's empty. So let's just run that service start my one, not service, system control start my one shot echo. And system control status my one shot. A lot of bullshit there. Okay. Inactive dead. Loaded disabled. Okay, whatever. But it did its work. So I'll search MHCTS 13.01. Are we clean? We're clean. Is that file there? Yeah. And then remove that again. So now let's just nano etc. System D, system my one shot, and let's just say run. Oh, and I need to actually, but I'll do that. Run con. I'll have a look at this. Man, run con. You actually need to. Oh yeah, compute. And then only use different range. So I'll say compute and then L, and I'll say S100. See if that works. And then ls, oh actually gcon l s100, and then serve instance 1 invalid argument, and it's c100. I made an error there. invalid argument as well though. Range. If I look, for example, at ls all z var lib lib vert, and then file system container one. Oh, it's actually c s zero, and then. So what you get is. S0 ls all z serve, and now we have the my one shot with category C100. So back to the unit file, because that was actually not right, I guess. S0, and instead I'm going to actually, oh, that's fine actually. So let's just try that. System control. Well, actually, I'm going to do it differently. And it sucks. I should have done that earlier. Nano user bin my one shot. And it's sbin, for Christ's sake. It shouldn't be sbin. Test date, and then ID. Set and force 0. I'm going to have to do this, and then and then got serve instance one, and then my one shot text, and that actually done, that actually worked. Our search and abcts recent. Out it to allow. Why is that Mac admin there? I should actually interpret that. So set X attribute. That's actually invalid context. Oh yeah, that's all, that's not applicable. Set and force one. Remove that file. And now start that again. System control start my one shot, and I'll get that again, and it created that. so I'll search abcts ds 1309. Nothing. So we're clean there. Now let's just add something. Sorry. Nano. My one shot. Type enforcement. And that is, let's make this UBAC constraint. UBAC constraint. Type. think, or it's you back on screen. Let's see what it is. My one shot. Make it. Install it. Let's see if it still works then. Set and for get and force, get and force. It's so it installed. So let's just for the shits and giggles, change the category to C200. And now 13, 11. LS all Z surf instance. So it's now it has category C200 instance. One, is it empty? No, it's not empty. RM surf instance one my one shot text. Yup. And so now it's empty, isn't it? Yep. And now let's try this again. System, and then we're in enforcing, get enforce. So system control start my one shot. Now it's probably started. That's actually not right. That's weird. It actually managed to create that file. PS aux grep Alexi. Just so weird. I'll search MAVCTS 13. No matches. It's 11. Let's just cut that file. Something weird going on. So, and why in the hell was it allowed? Let's try some, because I might just not. That's just so weird. But it might just be me. C2, C4. Oops. And then where is that goddamn C2, C4? So C3, C5. So we have it on, here we have, and that's all the serve instance one. We have it on C2, C4, and our service is running with a different and it may actually be that the write is not constrained. That may actually be the case. I should have, I would have to have a look at the constraints. Anyway, so system control start my one shot. And have a look at that, but I guess, oops, no. Yeah, so it actually is allowed to create it in there. That's so weird. But what? That's so weird. So, and it inherits the instance. C2, C4. That's so weird. So let's have a quick look. Or a quick, it's not going to be quick. But anyways, I want to see what is actually constrained. Because it seems that the write is actually not constrained. MCS constraints and these constraints. So here you have a file. MCS constraint type. So the write. Let's just try that again. Start and see if it can actually write to it. So if it what should be, if it's able to write to it, then it will append a line. And it's append constraint. Yeah, it should be a constraint append. So let's just that's so weird. So freaking weird. Let's just yeah, it just doesn't make sense to me. MCS file that's just so friggin' weird. This shouldn't be happening at all. This shouldn't be happening at all. As the info xt my one shot t. And it's a UBAC constraint type. Crazy. enforcing. Now you tell me, what the hell is going on? Let's remove that MCS constraint type, because maybe that's related. Although, don't see how. Nano, my one shot, TE. I'll comment this out. Yeah, I'll type that in. Make app user share as a Linux devel. Make file se module e my one shot pp. Now I don't know why this is. Yeah, it's still working. That totally blows my mind. Let's just add another rule just to troubleshoot this stuff. And put back in the EUBAC constraint. Because as far as I know, it shouldn't actually be able to. Do that. But it seems that it just is. Yeah. That's just so weird. So why is a process with C1 able to create? Able to write to a file with C2 and C4. You tell me. That should not be the case. That should not be the case. Am I overlooking something? Let's just make it a little bit more simple, or yeah, make it simpler, not that simple, I guess. It doesn't make much difference. This doesn't, something doesn't add up either. I'm just very confused right now, or just there's some bug in there. Yep, just seems to be a bug. I wouldn't know what else. See, the process is running with C1. Alright, so anyways, for now I'll leave it at this, because this doesn't add up for some reason. I'll take a break and then try something else.